And we discussed a very, very important topic, pressure versus pressure head. Can anyone recall? Anybody? What is pressure? What is pressure head?
We discussed about ideal gas thermometer.
In that only I discussed about pressure and pressure head, if you remember. Pressure versus pressure head. Right? So if you recall, we can write 1 atmospheric pressure is equals to, in SI unit we are going to write 1 bar. This is also equals to 760 mm of mercury, and this is also equal to 10.13 meters of water. That day I cleared how 1 atmosphere is equal to 10.3 meter. Anybody is having doubt? Last Friday I explained how to get 10.13 meters of water from 1 atmosphere. Clear? Anyone please reply. Still any doubt, I'll give a glance in 1 minute.
No, sir.
All right. Right. For that, what I considered a fluid, if you remember. Okay. So the basic fundamental equation we are going to use to convert pressure into pressure head equal to P is equals to rho into G into H, where P is the pressure and H is called pressure head. H is called pressure head. If you considered P as 1 bar, so that is nothing but 1 into 10 power 5 Pascal, nothing but 1 into 10 power 5 Newton per meter square. And if you take density, we are considering water as 1000 kg per meter cube. And G value, if you consider 9.81 meter per second square, if you substitute these values, you will get H value is equals to 10.13 meters of water. So always when the units are in meter, that is nothing but head of the pressure. And if the units are in bar or Newton per meter square, that is simply pressure. So you should have clarity about how to convert pressure into pressure head, pressure head into pressure. If head is given, we can calculate pressure by multiplying with rho into G. Or if pressure is given, we can calculate head by dividing the pressure by rho G. Very, very, very important concept throughout your engineering. Pressure versus pressure head. Clear? If it is clear, I will go to next topic. This is the thing we discussed in the Friday's class. Okay? And it depends upon the fluid you are taking. Because I am taking water, that's why I am writing in terms of water. Suppose if you are taking mercury, mm of Hg you have to write. Meter of Hg you can write. Okay? That day someone asked, if you take mercury, right? So if you take mercury, this will be a specific weight of the mercury you need to consider. Okay, that's it. Now, right. Can you tell me anyone, what are the absolute units for the temperature?
Kelvin.
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 Similarly, what are the absolute units for the pressure?
Bar.
Bar.
Okay, right. So usually temperature is used to represent in Kelvin. Always it is the absolute unit. Similarly, whenever pressure is there, so you need to convert into absolute unit. For that you require, let us assume, all of you please concentrate. So this is your atmospheric pressure. This is your atmospheric pressure. Let us consider this vertical line. Let us say now this is the pressure. Now what is the pressure at this point? At that line the pressure is 1 bar pressure. Usually if you go above the atmosphere, the pressure is positive. And if you go down the atmospheric pressure, the pressure is negative pressure. And if you go down, down at some point, the pressure will be zero. This is called absolute zero pressure. This is the absolute zero pressure. Okay. And we can call the pressure above the atmospheric pressure is called positive pressure, or it is other name is gauge pressure. Gauge pressure. The pressure below the atmospheric line is called vacuum pressure. The pressure below the atmosphere. Right? So usually in absolute scale, we can write P absolute is equals to P atmosphere plus P gauge. If the pressure is above the atmosphere, and if the pressure is below the atmosphere, P absolute is equals to P atmosphere minus P vacuum. Right now, P vacuum, right? Or we can write plus or minus. Positive pressure is the gauge pressure, negative pressure is the vacuum pressure. Let us consider, I have a point A here, I have point B here, okay? So if I want to measure the absolute pressure at point A, how to write, tell me. Always you should consider atmospheric pressure as the reference for that, always. So I want P absolute of A. So how to reach A? First you need to go from absolute zero to atmosphere. From atmosphere you should go down to the point A. Means from this pressure you should subtract this value, thereby you will get the remaining. This is the absolute pressure of A. For every pressure, our atmospheric pressure as the reference, that's why from absolute zero first you go to the atmosphere, and from atmosphere only you go to the required point. If the point is above A, above atmosphere, you should go up. If the point is below the atmosphere, you should come down. So that's why this pressure is the absolute pressure. This is the required one. This is the required one. So how to get P absolute at A? That is P atmosphere minus P vacuum. So that is the absolute pressure at A. Similarly, if I want to note down the absolute pressure at point B, P absolute at point B is equal, how to reach point B? First from absolute zero to atmospheric you have to go. Again from atmosphere you need to move further up, thereby you will reach the point B. So therefore we can write P absolute at B is equals to P atmosphere plus P gauge. Always we should consider absolute unit for the pressure, similar to the temperature. Any doubt in this one?
No, sir. No doubt. Right?
Always we will consider atmospheric pressure as the reference. And if you move above the atmosphere pressure, this line is the pressure line. This vertical line is the pressure line. If you move above the atmosphere, that is a positive pressure. We can call it as a gauge pressure. If you move below the atmosphere, that pressure is the negative pressure. We used to call it as a vacuum pressure. Okay. Now we will go to our ideal gas thermometer. Clear now this thing? Right. So ideal gas thermometer. This is the constant gas thermometer. Now we can see here. Sorry. Very, very important for the 10 marks question. Clear. Understand the working clearly. It is very, very simple. Very, very simple. Now, we have three bulbs here, bulb 1, bulb 2, bulb 3. Okay. And bulb 2 and bulb 3 are connected by a flexible housing. This is the flexible housing. It is a pipe. So due to this flexible tube, I can move this bulb B3 up and down. I can move this bulb B3 up and down. Okay. Now you can see initially there will be mercury in B2 and B3. So this fluid, this is the mercury, and this is in bulb B1 we have ideal gas, and B1, B2 are connected by a capillary. This is the capillary tube. This tube is the capillary tube. These two are connected by capillary. Okay. Now, so always you observe here, there is mark 0 over here. This is the reference. So always the mercury in the bulb B2 should be at mark O. Irrespective of the temperature, the bulb B1 is exposed. So we are calling the sensing bulb. So whatever the temperature we are exposing, you should maintain the mercury in the bulb B2 at this point. Clear? This is the first condition. The level of the mercury in bulb B2 should be at zero level. Okay? And this H can be varied. this H can be varied. Okay. Okay. Now, so as just now I discussed, the absolute unit will be P absolute is equals to P atmosphere plus P gauge. P absolute is equals to P atmosphere. Let us see, we are measuring positive pressure. P atmospheric plus P gauge pressure. Okay. I already explained how to calculate the gauge pressure by considering a fluid in a container. Okay. By considering fluid in a container at the free surface, the pressure is atmosphere. And if you go below this one, if you go below this one, now this is the head corresponding to this head point, and this is the head corresponding to this. If you multiply with specific weight, you will get the absolute pressure at that point. And if you add atmospheric pressure for that, you will get the absolute pressure. Clear this one? Clear this one? Why I wrote P is equals to P atmospheric plus rho gh? Very, very important.
Sir, we are going down now, sir. So we should write P vacuum now.
No. If the pressure is, if you are measuring below the atmosphere, only in the figure I am going down. Getting or not? If you move above the atmosphere positive, below the atmosphere, whenever the fluid is open to the atmosphere, the pressure is atmosphere. Usually, I will give an example. Let us consider a three-storied building. Let us consider a three-storied building. Okay. Here at the top of the building, what we contain? This is the what? Your water tank. Right. So water tank, let us assume it is open to the atmosphere. What is the pressure acting over here? Can anyone?
1 bar, 1 atmosphere. 1 bar.
Nothing but 1 atmospheric pressure, right? Suppose yes. If you are going, because your building is down the water tank, it doesn't mean that it is a negative pressure. Agree?
Yes, sir.
It doesn't mean that because we are going below the atmosphere, it is not going below the atmosphere. The what we call the floors are below the tank. That's it. Even let us say in the building, if you take one bowl and if you pour water, the pressure is atmosphere only. Agree?
Yes, sir. In the right. Bowl, it will change.
In the bowl, it will change. That's what. Right. Again, let us assume we have three water connections here. We have three water connections in three different floors. Okay. So this is floor one. Floor 2, floor 3, and through pipes we connected the waters. Okay. Now tell me where you will get more pressure. This is one water, 2, 3 taps we have. Where you will get more pressure? Can anyone answer?
3.
This is water we are collecting, let us say. Where we are getting more pressure of water? 3, 2, 1. Anyone? At first floor or third floor? Very simple, very logical question.
Last floor, sir.
Don't say last or first. No. Never tell me. Huh?
First floor.
Sir.
First floor, sir.
First floor, okay? Because always, if you recall the Saturday's topic, I considered two points in the bowl. This is point A and this is point B, right now? So this is the free surface of water. The height of the point A is HA. The height of the point B from free surface of water is HB. Where the H value is more for A or for B?
B.
B, right? Usually pressure is equals to rho into G into H. When the H value is more, the pressure is also more. Yes or no, right? If head increases, automatically pressure increases. Agree?
Yes, sir.
That is the reason your first floor tap is at a height of, this is the free surface of water. This is the head corresponding to first floor. This is the head corresponding to second floor, H2. And the remaining is the head corresponding to third floor. Where you are having more head? Where we are having more head? Roll number 5. Roll number 5, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell me where the head is more. H1, H2, H3 are there. Where the head of the pressure water is more. H1 or H3?
Sir, H1.
H1, right? So that is the reason we are getting more pressure of water at the ground floor as compared to the top floors. Always ground floor people will get more pressure because the head of the water is more with respect to the tank. Clear this concept? Is this is clear or not?
Clear, sir, clear.
Clear, right. Now coming to the working, I already explained about triple point of water. Okay. What is meant by triple point of water? The temperature and pressure at which the three phases of water, that is nothing but ice, water and steam, are in equilibrium. Okay. So this is the pressure corresponding to triple point and this is the temperature corresponding to the triple point. Okay. First, what we are going to do, this is the sensing bulb. So B1 is the sensing bulb. This is we are going to expose to the temperature that is to be measured. Agree? So B1 is the sensing bulb. That bulb is exposed to the temperature where we are going to record the temperature. Okay. And one more condition is the level of the mercury in B2 should be always at zero level, irrespective of the temperature exposed. Okay. Let us assume, listen carefully, very, very important thing, only two lines only working. Now, first, let us say the bulb B1 is exposed to the hot triple point temperature. First, why we are going to exposing to the triple point? Because every instrument I already told, before making use, you should calibrate it. You should calibrate the instrument in order to get the correct readings, right? So that is the reason, first the bulb B1 is exposed to the triple point of water, because triple point values are known. The pressure is known to you because PTP is known and temperature of triple point is also known. Agree? Because PTP, if you see here, 4.58 mg and 0.01 degree centigrade. Okay. So triple point pressure is 4.58 mg and 4.58 millimeter of mercury. Okay. 4.58 millimeter of mercury. Millimeter of Hg mercury. Okay. And this is, these values are always fixed. These are the triple points of water, right? First, the gas bulb is exposed to which temperature? Triple point temperature means 0.01 degree centigrade. Why? Because these pressure and temperature are known to me. Because first I need to calibrate with respect to some standard value. This is the standard value, triple point of water, right? Let us assume, usually bulb before the thing is, it is under room temperature. Room temperature is around 24 or 25 degree centigrade and triple point temperature is very, very less than this 25 degree centigrade. What happens to the gas present inside the bulb? I want answer from you. Earlier the bulb is at room temperature. Now we are exposing this bulb to the triple point of water. Triple point of water temperature is 0.01 degree centigrade. It is very, very less than the room temperature. What happens to the pressure of this particular or volume of this particular thermometer? So the name itself is indicating that constant volume. So in constant volume thermometer, what is the thermometric property? Rule number one, please answer. What is the thermometric property of the constant volume thermometer?
Sir, it decreases, sir.
No, I am asking, what is the thermometric property for constant volume thermometer? Anyone can answer?
Isobaric, sir.
No. Which property is going to change by keeping volume constant? That is the meaning. The thermometric property is the property which changes according to the temperature. If you expose to the temperature, the properties are going to change. If you recall, I will go to the slide again. If people are not at all going to the slides. Sorry, tell me anyone. You can see here.
Isobaric.
No. If the gas is heated by keeping volume constant, what is its thermometric property?
Pressure increases.
No, I'm not asking increase or decrease. Which is the property here going to change? Pressure is the thermometric property, which is going to change by keeping volume constant. Suppose, for example, if you keep pressure constant, which is the property is going to change?
Volume.
You should not forget that, right now?
Yes. Okay?
Right. So we are, it is a constant volume thermometer. For constant volume thermometer, thermometric property will be the pressure. One second, it got stuck. Right. Now is it is clear? Is it is visible?
Yes, sir.
Right. So as I told, first the thermometric bulb should be exposed to the triple point temperature. First thing, it should expose to the triple point temperature. Right. As the temperature of triple point is 0.01 degree centigrade, it is less than the atmosphere, less than T atmosphere. So what happens to the volume of the ideal gas, tell me, will be increased or decreased? If you decrease, if you decrease the temperature, what happens to the volume?
Increases.
What is the ideal gas equation? PV is equals to M into R into T. What is the relation between volume and temperature?
Directly.
You increase the temperature, volume will be increased. If you decrease the temperature, volume will be decreased. Now we are decreasing the temperature. What happens to volume?
Decreases.
It also decreases.
If the volume decreases, what happens? This gas can occupy less than the earlier volume. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Right. So the gas can occupy less than the earlier volume. Thereby, the mercury, listen carefully, the mercury in the bulb B2 will move in which direction? This mercury
downward.
Level. Hey, because this volume is decreased, therefore this mercury will move
upward direction.
Then what you need to do, you need to adjust this bulb B3 by using this flexible tube, right? So the main advantage of this flexible tube is you can move this bulb B3 up and down, that is according to our requirement, right? Now here the mercury is moving upward direction. I need to bring back this mercury down. What I need to do, I need to move this bulb B3 downward direction. Thereby, this mercury level in bulb B2 will come to the original position O. This is the reference level. Agree or not?
Yes, sir.
Right? So, because of decrease in the volume, this mercury in bulb B2 is moved upward direction. Always the reference should be 0 for B2, that is fixed. In order to do that, you need to move this bulb B3 downward direction. So if you move bulb B3 downward direction, what happens? This H value is also going to change. That H will be recorded. This H will be corresponding to a triple point. And by using this formula, this is the H we are going to HTP. And this is the PTP. If you calculate that, this pressure, if you calculate this, this should be equal to your 14.8. What is the triple point pressure? 4.58 mg of mercury you should get it. 4.58 mm of mercury. Why I am writing mm of mercury? Because my fluid is the mercury. Because the fluid is the mercury, that's why I am writing in terms of Hg. Your fluid is different thing, you need to write in terms of that. Got it or not?
Yes, sir.
HTP I am measuring. This HTP value should be 4.58 mm in the scale. Let us say here backside of the scale, there are divisions are there. Let us assume when it is 0, this is 0, here 1, here 2, 3 mm, 4 mm, like that, 5 mm. If you measure, it will be 4.58. Then if you got exactly this value, when you expose the bulb to the triple point temperature, then we can say that this instrument is perfectly calibrated. Agree or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So yes, sir. See, let us assume after exposing to the triple point temperature and after getting this reference zero, suppose instead of 4.58, you are getting, let us say, 4 mm. What does it mean? Did you got my question? Let us say if the height corresponding to this mercury is 4.58 mm, then I can say that it is perfectly calibrated. Suppose I am getting only 4 mm of mercury, is it is equal to triple point pressure?
No, sir.
So it is, then you need to add some mercury to that till you are getting the level as 4.58. That is the way we are going to calibrate. Suppose you are getting 5 mm of mercury, so means it indicates that there is some excess of mercury in the bulb. You need to remove till it is reaches to the 4.58. This is the way of calibration. Agree?
Yes,
yes,
sir.
So now is calibration is clear for anyone?
Clear, sir.
Right. I am assuming that everyone is clear. First step for the ideal gas thermometer is calibrating, right? So by exposing the bulb to the TTP, we are getting the yes, mute your mic. Somebody unmuted. Somebody is singing a song. Okay.
Sir, can you repeat this, sir?
First, the gas bulb is exposed to the triple point temperature, that is 0.01 degree centigrade, and corresponding pressure we are noting down. Let us say I am getting 4.58 mm of mercury. Now tell me, I am saying it is a pressure, but I am writing in terms of mm. Tell me, what is this 4.58 mm? Is it pressure or pressure head?
Pressure, sir.
It is pressure
head.
Right? So though I am saying it is a pressure, but the units are in mm, so it is a pressure head. I am getting 4.58 means whatever the mercury contained in this bulb will be correct. Need not to add any mercury or need not to remove any excess mercury. Means it is perfectly calibrated. That is the first step. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now what we are going to do, second step. Now we are exposing the bulb to the unknown temperature. Now this bulb, let us say, yes, please mute your mics. Now what we are doing, let us say this is the water bath. Let us assume this temperature is greater than the atmospheric temperature. Let us assume we expose this gas bulb to the temperature more than the atmosphere. What happens to the volume if we expose the bulb above the atmosphere temperature?
Volume increases.
If you increase the temperature, volume will increase. At the same time, pressure also increases right now. If volume of the gas increases, what happens to the mercury level in bulb B2 will be moved downward direction. Agree?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So the mercury in the bulb B2 is moving downward direction, but our reference is always zero. Then in order to bring back, let us assume the mercury is come here. Now we need to bring back this level to the zero level. For that, what you need to do? You need to move the bulb B3 in the upward direction. Listen carefully. If you move this bulb B3 in the upward direction, then this mercury will come to zero. You need to move upward direction till the mercury level in bulb B2 should be at zero level. Then the corresponding head you need to note down. This head of unknown temperature. This head you need to note down. Got it? Once head is known, the pressure is also calculated. P is equals to P atmosphere plus rho into G into H unknown. So this is P of unknown. Agree? Please reply. Anyone?
Yes.
So after exposing the bulb to the highest temperature, its volume is increased. Thereby, the level of the mercury in bulb B2 is pushed downward direction because of increase in the pressure and volume, and I need to bring back this level to the original reference. For that reason, I am moving the bulb B3 upward direction. when if I move this bulb B3 upward direction, the H value is also going to vary. Thus, that corresponding H value is corresponding to the pressure, right? So this pressure is we are calibrating in terms of temperature. Now, after getting the H value, I am getting the P. Then by using this relation, so P by T is always constant. P by T is always constant. P triple point to the T triple point is equals to P unknown pressure to the T unknown. So I want T unknown. This is required. That is P unknown into T triple point temperature by P triple point temperature. By using this formula, we can calculate the temperature of this exposed water. Clear? This is the simple formula we are going to use in constant volume gas thermometer. Is it is clear working or still you have any doubt, please ask me. Very, very important compulsory question. From first unit essay will come.
Can you explain that last part, sir? Can you explain that last part once again?
Okay, right. With help of screen, I'll explain. Right. So, usually TTP we know and PTP also we know. Agree? These two are the standard values. By using these values only, we are calibrated the gas thermometer. This is 0.01 degree Celsius. This is 14.7 mm of or 8 mm of mercury. These values are standard value known to you. Now, I am going to expose some unknown temperature, but the corresponding rise of pressure I can note down. P unknown is equals to absolute scale I am taking P atmosphere into rho into G into H unknown. This H unknown is the corresponding the level of mercury in bulb B3. This is bulb B3. This is H unknown. After adjusting the level of mercury in B2, this H value you need to note down. Okay. So by using this, I am calculating P unknown. As we know from ideal gas equation, PV is proportional to RT and pressure and temperature are directly proportional to each other. So therefore, P triple point to the T triple point is a constant. So that is equals to P unknown by T unknown temperature. If we equate these two, the unknown temperature of T, it can be calculated as P unknown into T triple point by P triple point. In this value is known, this value is known, this value we calculated, thereby you will get the required temperature. Now is it clear? Any doubt, please
yes,
ask
sir.
Me. Very important. Compulsory question for 10 marks. Explain the construction and working of ideal gas thermometer and how you will calculate the temperature. Clear? Please tell me. If it is clear, I will go to next slide.
Yes.
Go to the slide where we are 61. Right. Now I will show you a small video also. One-minute video. All of you able to see the video? Just I paused just now. Are you able to see the image?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The gas thermometer.
Sir, full screen, sir.
Is the gas?
It's full screen, huh?
Yes, sir.
Now I am playing.
You can see the gas thermometer. Yes, sir. Okay, so we're going to raise the gas. We'll raise warm water into the gas and the gas will expand. Notice we've got the starting levels of the mercury with the two arrows there. Then as the warm water heats the gas will expand, which will force the mercury down on the right-hand side and up on the left-hand side. But this will also increase the pressure as well as the increase in volume. So when it reaches equilibrium and the two levels of mercury don't change anymore, then what we will do is come along, we'll grab the left-hand side of the tube and lift it further increasing the height of the mercury, increasing the pressure, which will then force the mercury on the right hand side to come back to the level that it started at. That's happening now. And when it gets to the level that it's starting at, we can see on the left hand side the height difference of the mercury, and from that we can calculate new pressure that the gas is under at the same volume. So now we're going to see the...
Right. Is it is clear or shall I explain by keeping it pass-pass like that, this video?
Explain, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, listen. Now, initially, this is one bulb. According to us, which is the sensing bulb B1, right? P1, B2, B3, right? The names we given.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes.
This is B1. You can see this one. Can you see my mouse cursor?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this
yeah,
is the
yes, sir.
Yeah, this is the bulb B1. This is the sensing bulb. And this is the bulb B2. And this is the bulb B3. Right? You can see here, the mercury in bulb B2 is at what level? 0. Every time you need to make sure that for taking the reading, the mercury level in this bulb is at 0. You can see, you can't see here. But here there is a connection between B1 and B2 at the top by capillary. I told one capillary is there. With help of capillary, this and this are connected. But in this video, it is not visible. Don't think that there is no connection between B1 and B2. There is a capillary over here. This capillary connects this bulb to this bulb. Clear? At least one give reply so that I can proceed.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes,
now, sir. Now what he is doing? He is exposing this bulb to the temperature. Let us say this temperature is greater than atmospheric temperature. So thereby what happened? This inside this bulb, what is there? Ideal gas is there, right? Like argon, helium, neon, whatever, some ideal gas is there. This gas is expands because of the temperature of the water. This gas will expand, thereby its volume increases, pressure increases. What happens to this mercury level in bulb B2 due to increase in its volume and pressure? Tell me. What happens to this level? Mercury level
decreases.
Because this gas will push the mercury downward direction. So we can see that one only. Now observe the. Now you can see B2.
As the wall B2, water heats, so you can the see gas, it is decreasing. Expands, which will force the mercury down on the right hand side and up on the.
Did you observe? After exposing the gas bulb to the highest temperature, the mercury level in B2 earlier is at 0 level. Now it is slightly moving downward direction. The corresponding rise is going to take place in bulb B3. Agree?
Yes, sir.
The left hand side. This will also increase the pressure as well as the increase in volume. So when it reaches equilibrium and the two levels of mercury don't change anymore, then what we will do is come along, we'll grab the...
Now you can see the mercury level is decreased to 20. Now what we need to do? We need to maintain this mercury level till 0. For that, what we need to do? This bulb has to move upward direction, because we can see that orange colored one, this is your flexible tube. So because of this, we can move this bulb upward direction. If you move this bulb upward direction, what happened? This level of mercury in this bulb will decrease. And the level of mercury in this bulb will increase. We can see that in next slide.
The left hand side of the tube and lift it, further increasing the height of the mercury, increasing the pressure, which will then force the mercury on the right hand side to come back to the level that it started at. That's happening now.
Now observe, he is moving this bulb B3 upward direction.
Now, and when it gets to the level that it's starting at, we can see on the left-hand side the height difference of the mercury. And from that, we can calculate new pressure that the gas is under at the same volume.
Right. Now tell me, when the bulb is B2 at 0 level, what is the head in the B3? What is the height of mercury in B3? I am asking.
20.
Right. 10 only.
10.
10. Right.
10, no? Sir.
10. Now, after adjusting.
Yes, sir.
One second. The H unknown I am showing you. Now, because H unknown, you should measure from the earlier level, not from zero. Agree?
Yes, sir.
When it is at zero, already the mercury in the bulb B3 is at 10. Due to the exposed to the temperature, the rise is only 50, not 60, because this 10 is already it is present within the bulb. Due to the calibration, the bulb thermometer at up to 10 mm, the mercury is already present, and due to the adjustment of this bulb B3, the mercury is raised to only 50 mm, not 60. Agree?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Is this video is clear, or can I play once again?
Sir, why didn't they keep the second mercury level at zero only first in the starting?
Means I need to, yeah, right. Very good question. I'll explain. Please mute your mic. Because initially, if you see, at this point of time, is this bulb is exposed to any temperature change?
No.
Now, what is present inside the bulb? Tell me.
Gas.
Right?
And our aim is to maintain this ideal gas volume constant. The aim of this experiment is to maintain the volume of this gas constant. So when this volume will be constant, when this level of mercury is at zero, then this volume will be at constant. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, can you tell me, at this instant of time, we have gas up to here. Agree or not? It is not visible to us. It is a gas. So therefore, till this point, this is filled with gas. That volume, we need to maintain the constant. So now, suppose if the mercury level is up to 20, the gas is expanded from here to here. I need to bring back this volume constant by raising the mercury till to zero. That is the reason I am maintaining zero level constant. To keep the volume of the gas constant, we are bringing every time the mercury in bulb B2 at to zero level. That is the main story here. Clear now?
Yes, sir.
Right. Right. You can see this is the formula I told. So T unknown, P unknown, 3 corresponding to triple point, P3 corresponding to triple point pressure, and T3 corresponding to triple point temperature, and P is the unknown pressure, that is P absolute plus P absolute is equal to P atmospheric plus rho g into H unknown. This is the formula. So from this, we can note down the unknown pressure. This is the P unknown, and if you substitute all three values, we will get the unknown temperature. This is the only one formula we are going to use to measure the temperature of ideal gas thermometer. Don't bother about the textbook. Different textbooks will give different story. This is the only concept. Clear na? Working of ideal gas thermometer?
Yes, sir.
It's already 11:15, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we'll stop today.